Hello, hello, everyone. My name is Marlon, and you have been summoned to Marlon Place. I've got a little game on itch.io called She's a Bit Sluggish. Friday evening on a college campus feels like a setup for some kind of movie. If only my life could be one of the cool genres. She said she found something neat to watch and was pretty excited about it too. We plan on watching what she found and maybe ordering some takeout. Some Chinese? Ooh, let's go. And it's not like I can go to my dorm. Fucking fumigation, man. It's not like the rats caused any serious damage. At least the professor loaned me the lecture hall while the dorms are being deratted. Poor rats. Still, got a place to chill and a cutie to chill with. Man, this place looks different at night though. Almost surreal. Glancing at my watch, it's about 5 minutes before she gets here. She's always punctual with this kind of stuff. Even back in elementary school, she had perfect attendance. Time for one last check to make sure everything's ready. Projector's working, seats are properly cushioned, screen is in place. I can't help but feel I'm forgetting something. The snacks? That's what I just said. Snacks, maybe? I peek inside my wallet just to make sure. Please tell me you got like $15. Just a quarter and a European quid? Oh, who am I kidding? I'd be lucky to get one of those tiny bags of chips. I make a quick trip to the snack machines in the hall and load up my bag with nearly all of its contents. Wait, was a quarter and a European quid equivalent to like $500? We just went over to the machine and dumped a shit ton of snacks inside of our bag? Alright, cool. Gotta love that exchange rate. Oh, okay. So we're like in the States or something. As I make my way back, I notice Dory by the door. Dory, what's good? It's a scene I'm used to seeing. Phone pressed to her head. Pacing back and forth. Wait, are we bugs? She's a bit sluggish. It looks like she has a slug on her head. She's a slug. Near audible shouting from the phone and her own distressed voice failing. Seems like she's arguing with her roommate again. I already promised to hang out with someone else. No, I don't mean, look, sorry. No, please don't, Yeah. I'll think about it. Thanks. She pockets her phone and turns to finally see me. Oh crap, sorry, Andrew. You didn't hear very much of that, right? No. Her shoulders relax and she lets out a sigh. Was that anything important? Sounded serious. No, nothing serious. Ask what's on her mind. Ask about the movie she brought. You said you found a cool movie, right? Oh, well, I was walking around the neighborhood when I saw Vela having a garage sale of some sort, and she had this on for sale for only $2. She yanks a small CD case from her bag and hands it to me. Esco what now? Yeah, I remembered you were really into this sort of thing, so I thought it would be a nice gesture. Wow, that's really nice of you. Let's go ahead and pop it in. He's getting a little bit too comfy. The classroom projector eats the disc and starts humming. I turn the lights down, make sure the volume is at a good level, and take my seat next to Dory on the makeshift couch. It's a bit cold, isn't it, Andrew? It's like room temp. Andrew then realized he is profoundly retarded. Actually, it is a bit cold. I pull out the blanket Dory brought from under me and drape it over us. Dory leans into my shoulder. Oh, is she gonna hanky-panky? Her antenna... Let me hold on. You have popcorn? Wait, we got snacks. We got snacks. We can open up the bottom of the bag, and then we can stick our antenna in there, and then it'll wiggle around when... No? Okay, I'll stop. Her antenna things brush lightly against the side of my head. Which head? This setup is the stuff dreams are made of. Hope the movie is good. I can't stop laughing. Okay. I'm okay, I promise. Hope the movie is good. 19 minutes later, the credits emerge from the bottom of the screen. This movie was 20 minutes long. So, what'd you think? Her tone carries some sense of expectation. The movie, you watch movies for the experience. The art design was certainly unique. Left unsaid was the nightmare-inducing character designs. Good lord, what the fuck was wrong with their faces and their eyes? I repressed the involuntary shudder. I look so weird. I can see why you like this stuff. Yeah, I liked it. I bite back my scream. So, wanna go another round? I mean, how about some food? I got some snacks from the vending machine. I open my backpack, spilling 3/4 of a vending machine worth of snacks before us. Is it all junk food? You idiot! You f***ing idiot sandwich! I prefer to call it bachelor meals. At least you brought stuff for sandwiches too. She reaches into the pile and pulls out some jars and Tupperware. Damn, we're just making sandwiches like these? What is she putting in there? Are we putting the snacks inside of the sandwiches? What's wrong with my leg? Am I a fucking cyborg? I thought I was an ant or something. I look like a robot. I saw this one recipe online I wanted to try. Think it had mustard and pepperoni and... I nod, hiding the fact that I'm trying to break the disc of god-awful anime behind my back. This was worse than Reddit's recommended anime list. God, Dory's first exposure to anime and it was that trash fire. Man, this is looking nice. Today was sandwich day in the cafeteria too. Man, can't believe I missed sandwich day. You didn't eat lunch today? She hesitates. Just had something to do. Didn't turn out so well. Had to skip to catch up on work? I wish. No, I don't. Huh. She scans the pile and plucks out the pickle jar. My roommate wanted me to plant some drugs or something on her ex's locker. Whoa. Okay. Yeah, I mean, he probably deserved it. That's what she told me anyways. A pause while she fights the jar. I'd place my money on the jar winning. But I got caught by the campus police and we both got in trouble. That's insane. She made you do that? Made is a strong word. I figured she'd know better than me about it, but that's what she's mad at me about right now. She hands the jar to me. Can you get this for me? Think I got it a bit loose. Sure. I mean, just open it. Yeah. With a simple twist, I remove the lid from the jar of pickles. Ta-da! One order of super vinegary pickles. Pickles? Thanks. Got any more jars that are stuck? No, that's it. You sure you don't want me to open up your jar? Yes, Andrew. Just that one jar. Absolutely positive?
Yes!
By now, our meals are more or less finished and we dig in. What'd you make? Plain old club sandwich. You? We both glance at the glob between two bread pieces she's made. I don't know. It's good though. She holds it over, offering a bite. I'll take your word for it. We share our meal making small talk and sipping soft drinks for a while. And I like the part where they, what did happen around then? I don't remember. I don't either. Weird. Dory checks her phone and her face goes a bit paler than usual. I gotta take this. Sure. She flashes an apologetic smile and steps away, putting the phone to her ear. I try not to eavesdrop and focus on finishing my food, but I can hear the yelling through the speakers from here. Right now, make it up to- I told you I'm with someone else right now. So that's how you- all this time? No, come on, I don't- need you. You know that barkeep, right? Just come along. Be fine. You promised after last night I didn't have to go anymore. Okay, sorry, yeah. I'll be there soon. She hangs up and glumly approaches. Hey, I heard. Is it something serious? Dory scuffs and lowers to the side. Hardly. She wants me to be her wing woman at some bar. That doesn't... I had to cover the bill last time and find a ride home by myself, and she ruined one of my favorite dresses. Each word is punctuated with her stuffing something roughly into her backpack, even some of the snacks. This bitch trying to steal my snacks. She better stop. Then don't go. Dory pauses, her frown marring her pretty face. Your roommate's a colossal bitch, Dory. She's clearly put you through this bullshit before and probably isn't going to stop soon. So how about for once you put her through some? Stay here, with me. She pauses in the middle of packing her bag. I don't know. I do want to stay a while longer, but I promised my roommate to go with her tonight. I thought you didn't like doing that stuff with her. I don't. Why not tell her that? Never really thought to, I guess. Okay, let this be the first time. Maybe now's the best chance to... Hey, Dory. Her phone again. She hesitantly answers. There's no yelling coming through, so I can't hear the other end. Yes? I already said I am coming. She glances at me. Actually, I wanted to talk to you about some stuff. Yeah, okay. See you. She puts her phone away and starts backing away to the door. Thanks for the advice, Andrew. Ah, I'll go talk with her about it. Sorry about having to leave early. Maybe next time? Wait, Dory, I wanted to... confess my love for you. Next time, Andrew, I promise. You should pick the movie too. This was fun, but I really need to be going. Dory, I... Later, Andrew. The door already shut. Looks like I blew it. Me and my big mouth. Things were looking so well too. But, Dory said next time. Next time for sure. I'll really tell her how I feel. And also... pick something actually worth watching. But I'll tell her for sure. All right, you guys. We're back at this spot here. I picked the same choices from before. So we asked her about which movie she picked. Whatever the second option that I picked was, I picked that one as well. And then now, instead of opening the jar for her, I'm going to just loosen it for her. So let's see what that gets us. I pretend to exert an extreme amount of torque as I slowly twist the lid. I sigh in false surrender as I hand Dory back the partially open jar. Ugh, it's on way too tight. Really? Dory nearly spills all the pickles on her dress when the lid pops off in her hand. Oh, I got it. Oh yeah. Looks like you didn't need my help after all. She proudly starts forking pickles onto her increasingly chaotic sandwich. Wait a second, you could have just opened it. What? I didn't do anything, you saw. That was all you. She tosses a pickle at my shirt, you dork. By now our meals are- no, okay, I can skip this. Stay here, with me. It's fun watching her blush. As her cheeks warm, they become a soft pinkish purple. Stay with you? I nod. My fingers wrap gently around her hand, lowering it and her backpack back onto the floor. Yeah. Stay with me. Andrew. Her fingers intermingle with mine, the feeling of our palms pressing together sending goosebumps up my arms. Is this? I simply smile and nod again. Her face is now near completely pinkish purple. Magenta? Lavender, maybe. Her eyes dart all over the room as she sputters an inconceivable mess, even to the phone that's buzzing loudly on her chair. What? I have to fight back my snickers. Everything about her is so cute. Even her overreactions. I lost against the snickers. Which gets a new reaction out of Dory. Andrew. She has the sweetest pout on her lilac, maybe, face. Her free hand starts slapping at my chest. I'm sorry. Finally, her slapping stops. She buries her face against my chest, hiding it from view and muffling her voice. It's not funny. Was kind of funny. Was not. Her face is so close when she looks up. Dory, her eyes shimmer and her voice is a tiny whimper. I'll stay. It feels like the world is muted. Her head is slowly moving closer. Her eyes begin to close. Are we finna kiss? Nice. So we got a kiss. That was awesome. I like that ending way better than the first one where she kind of just got up and dipped. So there we go. We We got two different endings. We got the ending where she leaves, and we got the ending that satisfies our souls.
Your soul.